Dear student, with respect to this topic, that is stereochemistry of disubstituted cyclohexane, I have already posted 5 videos. Now this is the last video regarding this topic. So up till now, what we have finished, 1,1 disubstituted cyclohexane, 1,2 disubstituted cyclohexane, and all these 1,2, 1,3 and 1,4, among that up to cis, we have already completed. Now in this video, I'm going to talk about the trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane. So trans 1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane, as I already explained, first always go for planar structure. After drawing the planar ring, then you number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then select the position 1 and 4, that is 1 and 4 position. Then look at the geometry. It's a trans geometry. That means one is a wedge bond and the another is the dotted bond. So the possibility at the first position that I have taken is a wedged methyl group, and at fourth position it is a dotted methyl group. The another possibility can be a reverse, that is at first position the methyl group can be dotted and fourth position it will be wedged. After completion of the planar form, then we have to go with the chair conformer of this. Now, always remember, after drawing the chair, first you put the number 1 carbon to the top of the chair, number 1, and complete the remaining numbering in the clockwise manner. And then you select what is the requirement in the planar structure. So in the planar structure at one position, we want a beta methyl group. So beta is the bond going in upper direction. Now here the bond going in the upper direction is the axial bond. So that bond is axial. Hence, what I had to write here, this bond is axial. And at the same time, as it is going in the upper direction, so it is a beta bond. Now this at C4 methyl group, now this is again a axial bond. But at the same time, that bond is going in a downward direction, so it is an alpha bond. Now look at the ball and stick model of this structure. Now you can see here that this methyl group, that is number 1 position, so this is number 1, this is number 2, and here 3 and 4. So at 1 and 4 position, both the bonds, both the substituents are axial. So name of the conformer is AA. So once you complete one conformer, always remember you have to go for the flipping of this ring. So after flipping, what are the changes during flipping? This portion is going in downward direction and this portion is going in a upper direction. So number 1 is at lower side, number 4 is at upper direction. So what are the changes during flipping? Axial changes to equatorial, and this axial again changes to equatorial. So both axial group changes to equatorial. So this is a EE conformer. Now next, talk about the ball and stick model of this conformer. So after, now this is a 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now you can see both these substituents are equatorial and equatorial. Now as you know, whenever an axial substituent is there, it having a Witten-Gauss interaction. So which one is more stable structure? The EE conformer is more stable. That's why the more arrow, that is the larger arrow is toward that at the equilibrium, the more population is of EE conformer rather than AA conformer. Now let us go with the energy calculation. So first of all, we'll calculate energy for the AA conformer. So which are the two Butengauche interaction for C1CH3? So for this, how many different Butengauche interaction? So this is first Butengauche interaction and this one is the second Butengauche interaction. So for this methyl group, two Butengauche interactions are there. Now look at for this methyl group, how many Butengauche interactions are here? Again, there are two Butengauche interactions. Which are those? This is the first butane-Gosh interaction, but it's C4CH3 causing having interaction with C6 axial methyl group. At the same time, that C4CH3 having one more interaction, that is butane-Gosh interaction at C2 axial hydrogen. So overall, how many butane-Gosh interactions are there? Overall, there is this two interaction and this two interaction. So total interactions are 4. And how we calculate the energy for this? So C1CH3 is axial. So 2 butane-Gosh interactions. So it is 1.8. Again, C4CH3 is axial. So again, that energy is 1.8. And what is the last C1CH3 and C4CH3? What is the relation between them? It is 1,4. And how is the orientation or which bonds are there? It's axial-axial. So axial-axial, you can see they are far away from each other, so they never interact. So that's why the energy of this is 0. So total energy of this conformer is 3.6 kilocalories per mole. And as we already discussed in previous slide, this is a unstable conformer. So which is the stable conformer? The stable conformer is the EE conformer. So which are the which interactions are present? As both the substituents are equatorial, therefore C1CH3 is equatorial, no butane-Gosh interaction. C4CH3 is again equatorial, hence no butane-Gosh interaction. C1CH3, C4CH3 is 1,4-EE. Again, you can see they are far away from each other, so no interaction. So total energy of this conformer is 0. So this is a stable conformer for the trans-1,4-dimethyl cyclohexane. After completion of this, now we have to check the optical activity of the stable conformer. So which is the stable conformer? The stable conformer is the EE conformer. So for the optical activity, what is the first duty? First duty is to identify whether there is a presence of chirality center or not. So is there a chirality center? No. Look at the C1 group, that is C1 carbon. So first substituent is CH3, second substituent is hydrogen. Now the third substituent is CH2, again CH2. So when identical substituents are there, now you extend your next linking, that is C5 and C3. Again, they are CH2, CH2. Still there, these two groups are identical. So you extend your next linking. Now, for both, there is a CH-CH3 group. So what we conclude at the end, that this bond and this bond is identical, right? If they are the identical bond, now what we had to say, this C1 carbon not having a chirality center, and which is same or which is true over here at C4 carbon, there is also the same situation. So in other words, what we have to conclude, there is absence of chirality center or no asymmetric center. Hence, as the chirality is not there, the molecule is optically inactive. Now, whatever we discuss up till now. So what we discuss up till now, for the, that I have included in the table. So isomer. So how many different isomers are possible for this? So with respect to the conformations, cis-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, that is EA conformer, or EAE conformer, that are the flip structures of each other. And as you know, they're having the same energy, therefore they remain in equilibrium. So how many butane-Gosh interactions? You can see one action, that means 2 butane-Gosh interaction, and it is 1,2-AE relation. 1,2-AE relation, that is one more butane-Gosh interaction. So for axial, it is 2. And for AE, as it is 1,2, so total interactions are 3. Now look at trans-1,2. What is the conformer? Either you have a EE conformer or AA conformer. If EE conformer is there, as absence of axial, so no butane-Gosh interaction, but which interaction? Only this 1,2-EE interactions, only one interaction is present. In case of trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, as two axial substituents are there, two axial substituents, so for this 2 butane-Gosh interaction, for this again 2 butane-Gosh interaction, and 1,2-AA interaction is absent, So overall, 4 butane-Gauche interactions. So number of butane-Gauche interactions are like this. So with respect to that, you multiply it by 0.9. So multiply it by 0.9, and that gives you the final energy of this molecule. So 2.7, 0.9, and 3.6. Among that, which one is highly unstable structure? So this is the highly unstable structure, or we can say not exist at all. So among this, for cis-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, the energy is 0.7. And for trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, the energy is 0.9. So how much is the energy gap between these two conformers? The energy gap between these two conformers is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So which is more stable conformer? A trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane is more stable as compared to cis-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane by energy 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So the energy gap between the cis and trans is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Now this, the last column is regarding with the optical activity. Cis-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane is optically inactive because it exists in a non-resolvable DL pair. While trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane is optically active and exists in a resolvable DL pair. The second now, cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane and trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. For cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, what are the possible conformer? EE conformer and AE conformer. And for trans, it is AE or EA. They remain in equilibrium. So that we have written in a only single way. That is, only one isomer is possible for this, and both are interconvertible. But here, which isomer is more stable? This isomer is more stable because of absence of axial group. So equatorial cis-1,3, as equatorial means no butane-Gauche interaction, and the relation is 1,3. So if 1,3 relation is there, then this interaction is zero. So total butane-Gauche interactions are zero. Therefore, energy of this molecule is also zero. Now, cis-1,3, when the two groups are axial-axial, when two methyl groups are axial-axial, so how many butane-Gauche interactions are there? For this axial group, there is one butane-Gauche interaction. For this axial group, there is one butane-Gauche interaction. So total interactions are, that is, again, axial-axial interaction is there, that is 3.6 kilocalorie per mole. So total interactions are, that is, at the end, the total interaction is, that is, 4 butane-Gauche interaction, or we can say that is 2 butane-Gauche interactions regarding with one axial substituent, and one axial substituent, that is 2 plus what? 3.6 means, again, there is a 4 butane-Gauche interaction, 3.6 is. So total energy of this molecule is 5.4 kilocalorie per mole. And at the end, it is trans-1,3, that is actual equatorial or equatorial axial. Only one axial substituent is there. So there is a 2-butane-Gauche interaction. So the energy of this molecule is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. As this 5.4 is highly unstable structure, therefore that structure not having any existence. So at the end, for cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, energy of this molecule is 0 kilocalorie per mole, and trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, the energy of this is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So at the end, how much is the energy gap between these two? So energy gap between these two is again 1.8 kilocalorie per mole, right? So which one is more stable? Now in this case, the cis isomer is more stable as compared to trans isomer by the energy of 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. Now with respect to these isomers, what about the optical activity? Now cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane, it is optically inactive, or meso. So why the meso term is there? Because there is a presence of plane of symmetry. That's why this compound is optically inactive. Look at the stable conformer for trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. That compound is optically active and having a resolvable DL pair. Now, the last one is the cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane and trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane. For cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, the option is either EA or AE. Then trans-1,4, both can be EE or both can be AA. As one actual substituent is there, therefore two-butane-Gauche interaction. For equatorial-equatorial, no actual substituent, so zero interaction. For this actual 2-butane-Gauche interaction, for this actual, there is 2-butane-Gauche interaction. So total interactions are 4. So with respect to that, you multiply by 0.9. So this is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. This is 0 and this one is 3.6. So this is energetic structure, not exist at all. So the stable conformer for cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is AE or EA. The energy of this is 1.8. For trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, the stable conformer is EE. Energy of this molecule is 0 kilocalorie per mole. So how much is the energy gap between these two molecules? The energy gap between these two molecules is again 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So at the end, look at the energy calculation. So look at the, after looking at the energy calculation, what we see every time, the energy gap between the cis and trans isomer is 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. But in cis-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane and trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane, the trans-1,2-dimethylcyclohexane is more stable by 1.8 kilocalorie per mole than the cis isomer. But exactly it is opposite in case of 1,3-dimethylcyclohexane. Which isomer is more stable? Now, cis-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane is more stable as compared to trans-1,3-dimethylcyclohexane by 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. So this energy gap is, again, you can see here, 1.8 kilocalorie per mole. But if we look at the cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, that energy is 1.8, and trans-1,4, that energy is 0. So the energy difference between these two molecules is 1.8, indicating what? Trans-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane is more stable by 1.8. So look at the end, that is, in first case, trans-1,2 is more stable. In second case, cis-1,3 is more stable. In third case, again, trans-1,4 is more stable. So the optical activity of this cis-1,4-dimethylcyclohexane, as there is absence of chirality center, therefore, all these compounds are optically inactive. So for this, you refer the book